Okay, here the solid is a hexagonal pyramid with base side 30 mm and height 60 mm, and the solid is resting on HP with its base, with two sides of the base are perpendicular to VP. So we have to start from edge perpendicular to VP and having length 30 mm, and let us draw the hexagon by having an included angle of 120 degrees. So now we have drawn the top view of the pyramid. Let us draw the lateral edges. Then let us transfer the points to the front view. Now take the height of the solid as 60 mm. From the base mark 60 mm and draw the pyramid. Now let us mark the points. Okay, now we have marked the points. Now see the cutting plane. The cutting plane is inclined at 40 degree to HP, bisecting the axis. As the cutting plane bisects the axis, the total length is 60 mm. At 30 mm, it cuts the solid at the center. That's the meaning of bisecting. Now it is inclined at 40 degree to HP. So take your protractor and mark 40 degrees and draw the cutting plane. Then mark the cut points. The cut points are P dash, Q dash, R dash, S dash, T dash, and Q dash. Now we have drawn the cut points. Then take any arbitrary point O here. From that O, measure the true length of the lateral edge. For that, we have to rotate any edge, maybe OC or OD. I am rotating OC, OC, and making it OC to make it parallel to VP. So now it is parallel to VP. So when it is parallel to VP, draw a line from it vertically, and from that mark that line. So this is the true length of the line. So I have to measure from here. Here the true length is 67 mm. So at any point I have to mark 67 mm, maybe any at any angle. I have marked 67 mm. Then I have to rotate this line up to some arbitrary angle. Now take the base length. The base length is 30 mm, and mark 6 points as it is hexagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, now we have drawn the development of the uncut solid. Then we have to introduce the cutting planes. For that we need to draw the lateral edges, everything using thin line. Whatever I have drawn so far, it should be in thin line. Now mark the points in the development. This is A, B, C, D, E, F, again A. Transfer the cut points to the true line. This is the point P and U. So this is P and U. Then this is the point Q and S, and this is the point R. Now we have to transfer all the point to the development by measuring in the true line. Let us start from the point P. Point P and U are in the edge OA, and let us measure the distance. Here point P is in OA and point U is in OF. So point P is in OA at this distance. OA is at two points, the first point and the last one. So this is point P and this is point P. Then at the same distance, point U is here in the OF edge. So point U is in the OF edge. So this is point F. At this distance, point Q and T are located. Point Q is in the edge OB. Q is in the edge OB, I have marked here. And point T is in the edge OE. So at OE edge, point T is there. Then measure the distance of the point R and S here. Okay, at this distance, point R and S are in the edge OD and OC. At the edge OC, point R is there. At the end edge OC, point R is there, and at the edge OD, point S is located. At the edge OD, point S is located. So we got all the points P, Q, R, S, T, U, again P. So now we have to connect all the points using straight lines. If it is cylinder or cone, we have to connect using smooth lines. If it is pyramid or prism, we have to connect using straight lines. Now if you have connected all the points, then above those points the solid is removed, and below this point the solid are retained. So we have to retain and darken all the edges below this. Now we have darkened the portion below this thing. So this point OP, OE, OU, OT are removed, and this portion is retained. That's it. Thank you.